Hi friends, this is Yamini and I welcome you back to my channel The Saffron Box. Today in this video I shall be talking about the placement of moon in the second house in your natal chart. In the previous video in this series I spoke about what happens when moon is in the first house of your chart, that is in the ascendant or in the lagna. Right, so in this video I shall be talking about what happens when moon is in the second house of your natal chart. So here I'm talking about the natal placements. And what are the effects which you can see? What are the general results which you can see? Right, so to understand this, we'll quickly understand what is the second house all about. Right, so the second house stands for your family. It's called the Kutumbasthan. Right, so the first house is where you're born, and the second house where you meet your family or the immediate environment after your birth. Right, so the second house stands for your family, your kutumb, your initial upbringing, your basic education, your family values, the status of your family. It talks about your family. So what is the status? What kind of a family do you come from? Do you come from a family of lawyers? Do you come from a family of doctors? Of you know, whatever background your family has, that is seen from the second house. What kind of a family wealth do you have? Right, so what is the material inheritance, what is the material wealth of your family is also seen from the second house. And very importantly, it also talks about what kind of a you know, family values do you have in you. Right, so is it you know, what kind of sanskars your family has instilled in you, that is also seen from the second house. Right, so thereafter, the second house also represents your wealth. So when you talk about wealth, it includes your cash, your all the material possessions which you have, you know. So cash, your jewelry, there could be you know, bonds which you have, there could be shares you have, stocks you have, equity investments. So your valuable documents, shares, as I said. Right, so all these negotiable assets, your changeable assets, all these things are seen from the second house. Your precious stones, the amount of gold you have, right? So the amount of gold your family has, the family riches, they are also seen from the second house. Right, so second house also talks about your speech. So how is your speech? Second house is the Vanisthan, the Vakstan. So how is your speech? How do you come across? How do you sound to others? Do you sound nice and proper and polite? Or are you a little, you know, you sound a little rude, or you speak loudly, you speak softly, you know? So your how does your speech sound? Or what is your, how does your money be? So all these things are also seen from the second house. Your second house also talks about your right eye and your mouth. So what kind of eating habits do you have? Are you a quick eater? Are you a slow eater? Do you like spicy food? Do you like sweet food? Right, so do you like junk food? Are you disciplined about your food? All these things are seen from the second house again. Second house is the eighth from the seventh house. Seventh house is the house of marriage. And eighth house from the seventh, that is the second house, is the death of the first marriage. So your second house, your second marriage is also seen from the second house. Right, so a very important house again. It is also a Marakstan. So our own death is seen from the second house. Right, and the placement of moon here shows attachment towards the second house matters, because moon is emotions, moon is our mind. Right, so moon shows our manasthiti, our mental inclination. Where are we inclined mentally? Where does our mind finally go to? Right, so moon shows, you know, generally people with such a placement have attachment towards their families. They're very deeply connected with their family. Right, so they may like the family, they may not like the family, but there's a deep connection. Ultimately, they keep falling back to the family. Right, so whatever decision they take, they think about their family first. think about the reputation of their family first, right? So it's very important to them. And the placement of moon here also shows ups and downs, right? So there could be ups and downs because moon is a very fast moving planet. Moon is a planet which waxes and wanes. So there could be ups and downs here. So when, you know, we can take an example of say cash or money in your bank. So there could be ups and downs over here because moon waxes and wanes. So sometimes you could be really, really comfortable in terms of your cash, and sometimes you could be in a not a very comfortable state in terms of your money, in terms of your bank balance. The same could happen in terms of your relationship with your family also. So it could be, that's why I said it could be good, it could be bad, it could, there could be ups and downs over here, but attachment is always there, you know, one's mind is always there, right? Moon, if it is joined with it's conjoined with another benefic here, also would show that there is a the speech of the native is very good. One speaks softly, one speaks nicely, one could also make a living out of speaking. So this is the house which is very important in the case of teachers, in the case of orators, right? Public speakers, the second and the third as well. But second house again, since it's the Vanisthan, right? So a very important house again. And since the second house deals with cash, deals with money, deals with your possession, the second house is also a representative of banks, right? So there could be connection towards banks. So moon here shows that maybe one is inclined towards a profession in banking or towards a profession where money is being managed. So finance matters take importance here. One thinks about finance. So you'll find a lot of such people reading the financial news first, right? So when they open the paper, they read about the financial, you know, they take out the news regarding finance first. They're interested there. They'll be totally updated in terms of what is happening in terms of money matters, in terms of economics or banking related issues, right? So these are the kind of indications which one can see. The second house also, you know, since it is depends on the kind of benefic or malefic aspects you have here, it'll also show your speech, your eating habits, as I mentioned, right? So if there are a lot of malefic aspects over here, one could find that one is fond of you know, spicy food. Say Mars is aspecting, Rahu is also aspecting, you'll find that one is fond of spicy food. If there is a benefic aspect, if moon is seen by Venus or is seen by Jupiter, etc., one is fond of sweets, one speaks softly also, right? So one can study the impact. It's very easy to do. One can study what kind of an impact the second house has. Now from here, moon aspects the eighth house. Moon has only one aspect as we know, and that is the seventh aspect. So from the second house, moon directly sees the eighth house. So this could show an interest in eighth house matters, right? So there could be an interest in your partner's wealth, right? One could gain from their partner's wealth. There could be inclination or interest in astrology, right? So or hidden matters, eighth house matters basically. So secret affairs, astrology, hidden things, mining, right? So a lot of eighth house matters is what one is interested in also. But again, this is a general indication. It also depends on what is the strength of the second lord, what are the various aspects on the moon, on the second house, right? So these are again general results, but one needs to see the chart in totality to understand, right? So more or less that is about moon's placement in the second house. I'll come back again with the next video where I shall be talking about Moon's placement in the third house in our natal chart. Till then, do not forget to subscribe. And in case you're already a subscriber, thanks a lot to you. Do not forget to share the video. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.